Teach me your paths. Guide me in your truth and teach me, for you are the God of my salvation. I have hoped in you all day long. To you I lift up my soul, O my God. In you I have trusted. Let me not be put to shame, nor let my enemies exult over me. And let none who hope in you be put to shame. Remember your compassion, O Lord, and your merciful love, for they are from of old. To you I lift up my soul, O my God. In you I have trusted. Let me not be put to shame, nor let my enemies exult over me, and let none who hope in you be put to shame. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. To you I lift up my soul, O my God. In you I have trusted. Let me not be put to shame, nor let my enemies exult over me. And let none who hope in you be put to shame.
Good morning, and welcome to our celebration of the first Sunday of Advent. Our tabernacle flowers are donated in memory of Rowena May Bennett by the Bennett family. This Mass is being offered for George Cocoma. Before our opening song, I just want to let you know your worship guides are only good for the music. The readings are incorrect. Our opening song is O Come, Divine Messiah, Please Stand.
Thank you. As we begin this joy-filled season of Advent, begin by blessing this wreath. Lord God, your church joyfully awaits the coming of its Savior, who enlightens our hearts and dispels the darkness of ignorance and sin. Pour forth your blessings upon us and upon this wreath. May the light reflect the splendor of Christ, who is Lord forever and ever. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, as we do come together in joy to celebrate the joyful expectation, the coming of our Lord, to prepare our hearts, let's call to mind our sins, that we might enter into these sacred mysteries with a pure and contemplative heart.
Let us pray. I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters,
that I have greatly sinned
in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do,
through my most grievous fault.
Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Grant your faithful, we pray, Almighty God, the resolve to run forth to meet your Christ with righteous deeds at his coming, so that gathered at his right hand, they may be worthy to possess the heavenly kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. You, Lord, are our Father, our Redeemer. You are named forever. Why do you let us wander, O Lord, from your ways, and harden our hearts so that we fear you not? Return for the sake of your servants, the tribes of your heritage. Oh, that you would rend the heavens and come down with the mountains quaking before you, while you wrought awesome deeds we could not hope for, such as they had heard of from of old. No ear has ever heard, no eye ever seen, any God but you doing such deeds for those who wait for him. Would that you might meet us doing right, that we were mindful of you in our ways. Behold, you are angry, and we are sinful. All of us have become like unclean people. All our good deeds are like polluted rags. We have all withered like leaves, and our guilt carries us away like the wind. There is none who calls upon your name, who rouses himself to cling to you. For you have hidden your face from us. You have delivered us up to our guilt. Yet, O Lord, you are our Father. We are the clay, and you the potter. We are all the work of your hands. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Shepherd of Israel, hear us. Enthroned on the cherubim, shine forth. Rouse up your might and come to save us. Lord, make us tend to you. Let us see your face, and we shall be saved. God of hosts, turn again, we implore. Look down from heaven and see. Visit this vine and protect it, the vine your right hand has planted. The Son of Man you have claimed for yourself. Lord, make us turn to you. Let us see your face, and we shall be saved. May your hand be on the man at your right hand, the Son of Man you have confirmed as your own, and we shall never forsake you again. Give us life that we may call upon your name. Lord, make us turn to you. Let us see your face, and we shall be saved.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God always on your account for the grace of God bestowed on you in Christ Jesus, that in him you were enriched in every way, with all discourse and all knowledge, as the testimony to Christ was confirmed among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift as you wait for the revelation of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will keep you firm to the end, irreproachable on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful, and by him you were called to fellowship with his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Be watchful, be alert. You do not know when the time will come. It is like a man traveling abroad. He leaves home and places his servants in charge, each with his own work, and orders the gatekeeper to be on the watch. Watch, therefore. You do not know when the Lord of the house is coming, whether in the evening or at midnight, or at cockcrow or in the morning. May he not come suddenly and find you sleeping. What I say to you, I say to all. Watch." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So we've made it to the joyful season of Advent, right? We notice the Advent wreath, we see the purple, we're excited because Advent means the joy of Christmas is coming. Here it begins. It's a season of joyful expectation. We can dare to hope a little bit. We can be excited a little bit. It's a season of preparation, too. So we get things ready. We begin to prepare our hearts in this season. This season calls us to rouse from our drowsy faith and to watch, as the Lord just called us. The living, vibrant expectation of Jesus' power in our lives. In the gospel today, Jesus counsels us, be watchful, be alert, be ready. Be prepared at all times for the Master's coming. Who do you think is the most important person you've ever had over to your house? You know, who have you invited that you were maybe a little excited or a little nervous that they were coming over to visit, right? And how did you prepare? How did you prepare for this person's coming? I remember as a kid, when family would come, especially our out-of-town family, we would have to clean the whole house, right? Families come, especially like, I know for a lot of people, if the mother-in-law is coming, right? Oh man, we gotta make sure everything is spotless, right? We gotta clean the whole house, we gotta pretend like everything, you know, is perfect and clean all the time, right? It's interesting whenever I get invited over to people's homes, which a lot of people do for a house blessing or for dinner, the house is always immaculately clean. Like, it's beautiful, right? And the food is always really, really good. Like, if people's homes are always that clean and they always eat that well, man, you guys are living it up. Like, apparently life is good in our parish because the way I see it, it's gorgeous. Why? Why do we go to all this effort? Why do we go to all this trouble? If we're going to have an important guest over, if we're going to have family over, why do we clean the house? Why do we make the meal? Why do we go to so much work to have someone over? Well, the answer, obviously, is an answer of love. We want to show love. We want to honor. We want to respect the person coming over. And even in these little ways, in clean sheets, in folded towels, in an extra little zest to dinner, we show love, we show respect, we show honor. Well, this whole season of Advent is all about that. It's about getting ready for Jesus' coming. It's when we prepare for Christ to come. So guys, Jesus is coming. We've got to get this place cleaned up right away, okay? Everybody's got to do their part. We have to be ready for the Lord's coming. In this season, we speak of three different comings of Christ, right? You've probably heard this before. Christ's coming in history, which we celebrate in this season. Christ's coming in grace, which we celebrate in these sacraments. And Christ's coming in glory. The gospel today tells us to be ready, to be watchful for Christ's coming on the last day. Jesus ardently desires to come to you. He wants to come and make his home with you. He wants to dwell with each and every one of you. He longs for this. He desires this. In this season, we're transported back in history to the events before Christ's birth. We journey with Mary and Joseph through this season. We look forward with joyful expectation to the celebration of Christmas. The Lord loved us so much. He left the imperial heaven to be born a baby in Bethlehem. We prepare in history to celebrate that season. But the church also calls us, especially through the readings today and in this season, to prepare our hearts and our homes for Jesus' final coming in glory. Advent is a semi-penitential season because we need to put off the works of darkness and put on the good deeds of light. We prepare for Jesus' coming in glory when he will come to judge the living and the dead and repay each one according to his deeds. We prepare in this way. But also, lest we forget, Jesus wants to come to us on a daily basis. He wants to come and make his home with you today. He does this through his grace, through the grace of the sacraments here, which we receive, through a life of prayer, through the little gifts of grace we receive every single day that, unless we're paying attention, we might miss. So how do we prepare for these three comings? The Lord's coming in history, in grace, and in glory. Actually, all the same. Wake up. Get our house in order. Why do we prepare? Why? For the same reason. The love, the respect, the honor that we have for our Lord, that we want to show to our Lord. So let's get set to work. Let's vacuum up all the gossip on the living room floor, right? Let's sweep out the anger, right? Let's dust away the judgmental attitudes that we've been carrying. Let's clean all the hatred and unforgiveness out of the bathroom, right? Let's wash the jealousy out of our windows. Let's prepare ourselves. Let's get our house in order. Let's get ready and excited to welcome the Lord. Now, Jesus loves you. He does. And he wants to come to you no matter the circumstances. So he's willing to tolerate a little mess. Actually, he thrives in it. He'll help you pick up the living room when he gets there, right? The only thing that keeps the Lord out, that keeps the Lord away, is mortal sin, right? When our lives are such, when we've committed some act that locks the door from the inside. And if we're in this state of sin, if we need, the only way out is a good confession. So don't neglect to make your Advent confession. There's no penance rite this year, but we've extended the hours of confession. So again, you can get ready. You can get your house in order. You can unlock that door and have the Lord ready to run in and welcome him. Okay, who's begun decorating their house for Christmas? Whose tree is up? Yeah, okay, good. Who has already been decorating since before Thanksgiving? Okay, right, yeah, a little fewer hands, but I don't even blame you, right? This year has been a rough year. We all need that little extra joy, that little extra light, that Christmas decorations, that the joy of the season brings, right? That's great. We decorate our homes for Christmas. Who has begun already decorating your soul for Christmas? Do we even think about that? We need this joy too. We need this decoration, this ornamentation, because it's just as much a part of this season. You need the ornaments of good works, the garland of the rosary, kindness to others. The beauty in this season, so often we help the less fortunate. We look out for the lowly. We send extra expressions of love and joy by cards and messages. You want to make your soul, just as much as your home, a beautiful and ornamented place for the Lord to dwell. That's the call of this season. Why do we want that? Why do we go to all this work? Why do we put up Christmas decorations? The same reason. Love, honor, respect. Love of God, first and foremost, but also the joy that good works bring to us. The great joy that overwhelms us, knowing that we have prepared ourselves. We have opened our hearts to receive the Lord and made it a beautiful place. In the collect this morning, we prayed, Grant your faithful, we pray, Almighty God, the resolve to run forth to meet your Christ with righteous deeds at his coming, so that gathered in his right hand, they may be worthy to possess the kingdom of heaven. That's the joy, that's the longing that this season is called to draw out in us. That we may be so excited to receive the Lord, so excited to meet him, that we would run forth with righteous deeds. Don't let this season pass you by without working on the spiritual as well as the material. Don't let this season pass by without cleaning up a little, preparing a little, being excited to meet Jesus, letting that joy multiply in your heart, making a good confession, adorning your soul with some extra prayers. Prepare your heart to receive the Lord. Prepare your heart for his coming. And he loves you. He comes to you even today with his body, blood, soul, and divinity. May you always be prepared with joy to run out to meet him. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. In joyful expectation, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father of the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen. As we enter into this holy season of Advent, we ask God our Father to help us stay awake and make ready for the coming of Christ.
Our response this afternoon will be, "Give ear to us, O Lord. Give ear to us, O Lord." May all who exercise authority in the church, especially Pope Francis, Archbishop Paul, and all the clergy, be constantly aware of the presence of God in their midst, we pray.
Give ear to us, O Lord.
May all of us at St. John the Baptist take time during this holy season to recognize and give thanks for our day-to-day blessings, we pray.
Give ear to us, O Lord.
Let us live our lives to the full as Christians, announcing the good news to others in word and deed. We pray.
Give ear to us, O Lord.
That our candidates and catechumens will find this Advent season a time of preparation and anticipation for the coming of Christ. We pray.
Give ear to us, O Lord.
That our eyes will be open to the needs of those who are less fortunate than ourselves. We pray.
Give ear to us, O Lord.
for all those whose lives are filled with sorrow or sickness. May they realize God has not abandoned them. We pray.
Give ear to us, O Lord.
Grant eternal rest to those who have completed their earthly journey. We pray especially for Michael Hansen, brother of Ann Keefe, and for Glenn St. John, father of Carrie Mountford. We pray.
Give ear to us, O Lord.
And for the prayers offered in adoration of the Blessed Sacrament, and for all our personal intentions. We pray.
Give ear to us, O Lord.
Heavenly Father, as we prepare for your Son's coming again in glory, in your mercy hear our prayers and give us the grace to do your will. We ask this through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, we pray, O Lord, these offerings we make, gathered from among your gifts to us, and may what you grant us to celebrate devoutly here below gain for us the prize of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation. That when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which we now dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Paul, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants. And all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, where they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands. With eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. And once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance and to accept them, as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Prayer to St. Michael. St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. A few brief announcements. We are offering extended hours for the Sacrament of Penance, Sacrament of Reconciliation, for confession. We're not going to have our typical St. John's Penance rite this year, so we're extending our hours from 4 to 6 p.m. on Wednesday. So typically, it's 5 to 6 on Wednesday, but we've added an extra hour from 4 to 6. And on Saturdays, from 3 to 5. So normally, it's 4 to 5, but it'll be 3 to 5 on Saturdays. So there's plenty of opportunity for you to make a good confession this Advent season. If these times don't work for you, don't worry. We will bend over backwards, making sure we can hear your confession. Call the office. We'll set up a time together with any one of the priests and make sure that you have the opportunity to avail yourself of this wonderful sacrament, which we all need so desperately. What else we got? The Giving Tree is virtual this year, but we're still doing the Giving Tree, so please, we need your help to fill the needs of more than 750 gifts we provide each year to our community and the agencies that depend on us to have a blessed Christmas, so please sign up for the Giving Tree. There's an opportunity for a retreat coming up, sort of to reflect on the wounds that we've all experienced in 2020 and to find peace with Christ in the midst of chaos. It'll be part of a retreat series. It's offered two times, December 3rd and December 10th. You go come one or the other, a Thursday or a Saturday, and there are more details in the bulletin. Finally, the Feast of the Immaculate Conception is coming up. That's December 8th. The masses we'll have that day are 7:30 a.m. and 6:30 p.m. There will be a school mass at 9, but unfortunately, this year, due to the restrictions and whatnot, a school mass would be just for the students, so not open to the public. So plan to come for December 8th on 7:30 or 6:30. I hope you all had a wonderful Thanksgiving. I hope you're beginning to experience the joy of this wonderful season of Advent. Let us pray. May these mysteries, O Lord, in which we have participated, profit us, we pray. For even now as we walk amid passing things, you teach us by them to love the things of heaven and to hold fast to what endures, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
And sing today, love the blue.